Okay, we're going to talk now about how to survive your exit interview. This is yet another tip that I'm including in my series on midlife career strategy. So first, what are exit interviews? Well, generally, you will be asked to participate in an exit interview when you leave a job. Generally, if you leave voluntarily, you will certainly be asked to participate in an exit interview. And sometimes if the company decides to terminate you, they still want exit interviews. If you come to the end of a contract, you often have exit interviews. And sports team players often have exit interviews at the end of every season before they leave from their coach. They're often required. A lot of times a company, when you're leaving voluntarily, will ask you to do this in order to complete your processing, get your final paperwork in order. And generally, they're with a human resource representative or a senior manager in your own department. So what's the purpose of these exit interviews? Well, from the company's perspective, they want to diffuse your emotion, especially if you're leaving in a spirit of anger. Maybe you've been asked to leave or you're leaving unexpectedly. They wanted to keep you and you're leaving anyway. Maybe you have some strong feelings about your job, especially if you're leaving under some kind of cloud or there was overt or covert pressure to leave. And they want to remind you of company policies. So for example, maybe you've agreed somewhere along the way not to disclose certain information. They may have policies about material that you've acquired while working for the company, what you've got in your laptop, getting rid of anything you've accumulated in your office. And to be honest, a lot of people think they're there to give HR something extra to do, something that's often pleasant, something to pass their time, because HR needs to keep being reminded that they're vital to the organization. So what do you share with your manager or with HR when it's time to depart? What do you talk about? Well, a lot of people are tempted to help the organization. They say, I'm going to share my suggestions for making things better so other people won't leave like I did. And they want to help former colleagues because you say, you know, I get to leave. I've got a new job, but my poor colleagues are suffering back there. I'm going to try to help them. Or they want to warn of management problems. This is your chance to reach a senior manager or an HR person, and you think, hey, I'm going to use it. These strategies are a mistake, no doubt about it. You are not a consultant to the organization, unless they're paying you, in which case, then this is not really an exit interview, it's a consultation that they are paying you for. In my experience, when people want your opinion, they'll pay for it. If they want to change, they'll go out and hire a consultant. You generally have very little to gain from providing unsolicited information. Often your information, your suggestions will be ignored, things will go on, and you've generated perhaps some ill will, perhaps some uncomfortable moments, certainly some stress on your part. And above all, a lot of times a company will ask you, well, tell us about your new job. I've actually heard people say things like, well, we would like to know what you're getting paid because we want to know how to adjust our pay scale. You do not have to share that information. And most of the time, you will be advised not to, unless, of course, you're trying to get a competing offer. That usually has happened before you've got to the point of an exit interview. There is no reason to give any information. Just talk about how much you've enjoyed working for the company and just talk about how it's time to move forward. Make these two points. I loved it here. You want to say that even if you hate it every minute, at this point, there is nothing to be gained by being honest. I don't know about the moral aspects of this. Some people feel you should always be honest, but I cannot imagine a moral code that requires you to say how much you hated a place when it makes no sense. It will just hurt people's feelings at best and do some real harm to you at worst. And you would then go on to say, this is such a great opportunity. I could not turn it down. Talk about how it meets your needs and your satisfaction, and skip the details, as we said, about the position. And then move on. Within 30 to 90 days, this job is going to be a dim memory. You may think now, as you're facing your exit interview, you want to get it all out, you want to share things, but In 30 to 90 days, maybe even sooner, none of this is going to matter. So why bother? Why put in the energy now? Put the energy into your new endeavors. After you're gone, you are gone. Sometimes you do want to maintain relationships with supportive colleagues and bosses. If you're in a small industry, or even if you're not, they may be part of your network for the future. You never know. Sometimes you're working for a boss now, and he or she may come to you later needing a job. Or you may have colleagues who will start their own businesses and you want to work with them. Maybe you'll be a vendor. Maybe you'll be a supplier. Maybe you'll be a customer of theirs in the future. So you do want to maintain good relationships, but that means maybe sending cards and meeting later in the future. If you'd like to talk more about your strategy, I have several ways to work with clients. You can begin by going to my website, midlifecareerstrategy.com. And then on that website, you'll find a page, careerstrategysession.html. And I've got the abbreviation for you, budurl.com/careersession, one word. This is the way I work with people most of the time. We usually have one single session. We cover a great deal of ground during that time. I look at material ahead of time at your convenience, and we have follow-ups after the call. It's not just a single call, it's more of a program. I'd like to encourage you to follow up with me, and I encourage you to set up a call if you have any questions at all about your career. We usually get a lot done in a short time. This is where I'm different from many other consultants you've worked with. I won't try to sell you on a one-year long-term contract. We'll talk about getting your situation going in however many sessions you need, whether it's 1, 2, 5, 10, or more. Usually, we do a lot in one session. See you there, and best of luck with your future career.